evening, and welcome to tonight's unique presidential debate. Due to the candidate's unwillingness to leave his basement, Joe Biden will be joining us via remote live feed. Joe Biden will be debating one of his most vocal and ideological opponents, Joe Biden. Let's begin. Mr. Biden, as president, what is your plan to address the violence and riots which have taken over our streets in America?
There are two basic steps here. One step is you must take back the streets. And you take back the streets by more cops, more prisons, more physical protection for the people.
So do you believe in a stronger police force, Mr. Biden?
No. Nor is it acceptable for our police sworn to protect and serve all people to escalate tension.
So do you want to defund the police, Mr. Biden?
Yes. Absolutely. The last thing you need is an up-armored Humvee coming into a neighborhood. They become the enemy.
It is great, sir, to finally have you on the record supporting the defund the police movement.
I not only don't want to defund the police, I'm the one calling for $300 million more for local police.
Moving on. In Joe Biden's America, will there be a national mask mandate?
Every single American should be wearing a mask.
So, Mr. Biden, you would support an unconstitutional mask mandate?
No, I'm a constitutionalist. You know, you can't do things the Constitution doesn't allow you the power to do.
But you are in favor of an unconstitutional nationwide lockdown.
I would shut it down.
Would you also support unconstitutional infringements on our Second Amendment?
Bingo. You're right if you have an assault weapon. The fact of the matter is they should be illegal, period.
Sir, that directly violates the written word of the Constitution of the United States of America. Do you know the Constitution? Can you name a single line from a founding document?
We hold these truths to be self-evident. All men and women created by you know the thing.
Mr. Biden, would there be any place for fossil fuels, including coal and fracking, in a Joe Biden administration?
No, we would make sure it's eliminated and no more subsidies for either one of those. Either any fossil fuel.
So, Mr. Biden, you are in favor of banning fracking?
I am not banning fracking. Let me say that again. I am not banning fracking.
So, just to get that clear, you are keeping fracking, Mr. Biden?
You got to transition away from it. Sure, you're going to ban fracking all across America right now, right?
I would love to.
Yeah, I'd love to, too. I'd love to make sure we don't use any oil or gas, period.
Can that little teeny angry bald man you're talking to please get off the stage? Mr. Biden, once and for all, are you in favor of banning fracking or no?
No. I never told the environmentalists that I'm going to ban fracking, period.
So you are in favor of fossil fuels?
Look in my eyes. I guarantee you, we're going to end fossil fuel.
Mr. Biden, what are your views on marriage?
I'm the first major player to say I support gay marriage on national television.
So you do support gay marriage, Mr. Biden?
No, Barack Obama nor I support redefining from a civil side what constitutes marriage.
Unnecessary to throw President Obama under the bus like that? However, this answer is interesting. It is very out of touch with the progressive wing of your party.
Marriage is between a man and a woman, and states must respect that.
Mr. Biden, President Trump was the first president in American history to support gay marriage from his first day in office. What do you say to President Trump?
Marriage is between a man and a woman. What's the game going on here?
Well, President Trump is building a border wall at the border. Do you support his border wall?
So there are places where having a fence and extending the fence makes sense, and I voted for that. So it makes it more difficult for people taking large commodities and drugs to have to come around for us to be able to intercept.
So you agree, Mr. Biden, that walls work and we should build more walls?
No, there will not be another foot of wall constructed in my administration.
Okay.
And you're
stop. Moving on.
The fact is that...
Mr. Biden, switching gears here. What was your stance in voting for the war in Iraq?
I voted with my colleagues to give the President of the United States of America the authority to use force, and I would vote that way again today.
So to confirm, you're proud of your vote for the war in Iraq?
I made a mistake. I said it 14 years ago. I trusted George Bush to keep his word.
In light of the Me Too movement's popularity, do you believe all women?
The woman should be given the benefit of the doubt and not be abused again by the system.
Given that answer, Mr. Biden, do you believe the credible sexual assault allegations made against you by Tara Reid, which have been corroborated by multiple witnesses?
This never, ever happened. I don't know what is motivating her. I don't know what's behind any of it, but it's irrelevant. It never happened. It never happened, period.
What is your stance, Mr. Biden, on reforming our prison system?
It should be a rehabilitation system, not a punishment system.
So, Mr. Biden, you are in favor of rehabilitation instead of prison.
We don't very well know how to rehabilitate them at that point. So you cannot make rehabilitation a condition for release.
Speaking of prison reform, President Donald Trump passed criminal justice reform in a historic move, giving him one of the highest approval ratings in history from Black Americans.
If you have a problem figuring out whether you're for me or Trump, then you ain't Black.
Sir, that is just racist. Have you been tested for cognitive decline?
I've been tested and I'm constantly tested.
Well, it is good to know that you have been tested for cognitive decline, Mr. Biden.
No, I haven't taken a test. Why the hell would I take a test? Come on, man. That's like saying you, before you got in this program, you take a test where you're taking cocaine or not. What do you think, huh?
In closing, can you please tell us a personal story that is meaningful to you, Mr. Biden?
The kids used to come up and reach in the pool and rub my leg down so it was straight and then watch the hair come back up again. They'd look at it. So I learned about roaches. I learned about kids jumping on my lap. And I've loved kids jumping on my lap.
That is horrifying. Mr. Biden, can you please explain something that happened on the campaign trail that you learned about the American people?
You cannot go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent.
That was racism. Thank you very much for joining us for this illuminating presidential debate with Joe Biden versus Joe Biden. We hope that you learned about as much as we learned tonight about the candidate's many fascinating and racist and disturbing positions. Choose wisely, America. And Democrats, my heavens, what the hell have you gotten yourselves into? Good luck.